on hearing the name net zero, we might think that net zero emissions means reducing all our emissions to zero. If that's true, is it practically possible? Of course, it's happy to imagine a world that doesn't emit any greenhouse gases. But is it possible for us to stop using fossil fuels completely? The emissions from power plants, transportation, industries, agriculture, air conditioners, cooking, and the list goes on and on. Is it really possible to stop emissions from all these things in our life? If we try, we can stop most of our emissions. But for some industries like aviation, stopping the emission completely is really hard. Then, what does this net zero actually mean? To know more about this, continue watching. Hi, I am Vanilla. Today, I am talking about net zero. This is what happens to ice cream when it is exposed to higher temperature than it can handle. Similarly, when Earth's temperature increases, the Earth is going to face horrible disasters. But don't think that this is going to happen in future. It has already started. The greenhouse gases that we emit through burning fossil fuels are responsible for this. 1/5 of carbon dioxide emitted today will still be there in 10,000 years. As we emit more and more greenhouse gases, the temperature will keep going up. The hotter it gets, the harder it will for humans to survive. There is no realistic path to zero emissions. But what if we have ways to remove greenhouse gases that we emit? Then it will be easy to reach net zero. In other words, net zero refers to the balance between the amount of greenhouse gases produced and the amount removed from the atmosphere. This means if we can capture all greenhouse gases we emit before it enters the atmosphere, then our net emissions will be zero. But that doesn't mean that we can emit more greenhouse gases and then remove those. Because bigger the reduction, bigger the benefit. So the thing is, we must reduce our emissions as much as possible and we must remove the rest of greenhouse gases we emit to achieve net zero. How to remove the greenhouse gases we emit? During photosynthesis, plants take in carbon dioxide and give away oxygen. So, one of the ways to remove carbon dioxide is planting billions of trees. The other way is through carbon capture. This is the process of capturing carbon dioxide, transporting it and storing it underground. It is viewed as the only practical way to achieve deep decarbonization in the industrial sector. Companies and governments are investing more on this process. Researchers are trying hard to find an innovative and efficient solution. Hope everything pays off and we will reach the net zero soon. If you find this video helpful, please hit the like button. If you want to know more about why Earth is getting warmer and how we got here, please check my video on the journey of Earth's climate change.